So for Black History Month, I'm going to choose a famous music personality from over the years that I deeply respect and admire. For day one, I'm going with J Dilla, aka Dilla the God, the GOAT. This man was everything in terms of music production. He took that classic boom bap sound and mixed it with soul and pop and electronic, and he did it all from Detroit, man. In his later years, he moved to Los Angeles. He put in work with some of the greats over the years. Most notably was his work with Common, among many others, including Slum Village. He was equally as dangerous on the mic as he was behind the boards, and he passed away. And not a day goes by in my music that I don't pay homage to him and his style and his trend. So it's day two of Black History Month, and I'm gonna continue talking about famous music personalities. But since it's day two, I'm gonna talk about two, Quincy Jones and Michael Jackson. Without Quincy, there'd be no Michael. He produced all of Michael's greatest music, including the highest-selling album of all time, Thriller. Here's a picture of them in the studio enjoying their work, and you can hear their influence in almost everything that's going on today, from producers like Dilla, who I talked about yesterday, Dr. Dre, Kanye, Pharrell, Timbaland, all have took Quincy's model of being a composer, arranger, musician, and producer. Put that all in a blender and you literally have the greatest of all time. Michael went from working with Quincy to working with others and is considered one of the greatest artists of this generation. Salute to both of these geniuses. Every day for Black History Month, I'll be talking about a different music personality. For day three, I'll be talking about the late, great Jimi Hendrix, one of the best singer, songwriters, performers, musicians, and recording studio owners of all time. He was so far ahead of the curve, even as his early days as a backup singer and guitarist, all the way to later in his career as a festival headliner. He was truly amazing and a mind-blowing guitarist. His sound was so futuristic that they had to create new recording techniques to capture the inventiveness of the music that he was creating. One of the greats of all time, Jimi Hendrix, rest in peace. So for day four of Black History Month, I'm going to continue talking about music personalities. One of the great legends of R&B, soul, pop music was Nina Simone. She was a multi-instrumentalist, mostly known for the piano, but it was really her voice that was her instrument. She could recreate and compose entire songs with her voice and with claps and stomps. A true innovator and trailblazer in music. I suggest you do some research and check out as much as you can, especially her performance and in-studio visuals as she was creating music, what seemed like sometimes just from the spot, freestyle. One of the absolute greats of all time, Nina Simone. So what can I say about Stevie Wonder that ain't already been said? Literally one of the greatest recording artists and performers, singers, and songwriters of all time. I mean, this dude is the essence of the word legend, one of the baddest men on the planet. Even his age, he is still outperforming people that are younger and even more talented per se. But with that said, look at all the people that he influenced as an artist and producer. The list is extremely long, but he did influence people like Prince, Michael Jackson, even up to people today like The Weeknd, who write and produce a lot of their own content. Stevie wrote the blueprint for them to follow from his Motown days all the way till now, one of the greatest of all time. So for day six of Black History Month, I'm going to continue talking about musical legends. Today, I'm talking about Mavis Staples, the centerpiece of the Staples Singers, one of the best and most energetic live performers of all time. You might recognize her from just about every award show. Man, She crushes every performance. She was also an activist and an amazing multi-genre artist and songwriter. She influenced everybody from Prince to Michael Jackson to just about every female singer you could think of, including Beyoncé. Her music crossed all genres, from R&B, soul, and especially gospel. Make sure to check out Mavis Staples. For day 7 of Black History Month, I'm going to continue talking about our musical legends. Because it's the Super Bowl, I'm going to talk about Prince and his legendary halftime Super Bowl performance. Believe it or not, it was the most watched musical performance in all of television history. More people watched him perform even in the rain, the purple rain, as his purpleness performed a medley of his greatest hits in front of the largest television audience of all time. Prince influenced directly The Weeknd, who is performing tonight and is one of our future legends in music history. Take a chance tomorrow and listen to as much music by Prince as you can and study up on the man, the myth, the legend, and the artist formerly known as Prince. For Black History Month, I'm talking about music legends, and you gotta put some respect on Aretha Franklin's name. She's literally the queen of soul, one of the greatest singer-songwriters of her entire generation, the queen of Atlantic Records. A lot of people don't know that many other famous musicians, singers, and songwriters got their start either in her studio or touring bands. She was literally one of the most powerful studio singers and has made an amazing performing and touring career off songs that are way older than us that we all know the words to. Literally, the queen of soul. Let's all pay homage to Aretha Franklin. So for Black History Month, I'm going to continue talking about music legends. Today we're going to talk about Nile Rodgers, the band leader of Chic, who's responsible for some of the most amazing musical waves in history. He sold over 500 million units as a producer and 75 million singles worldwide. He's an inductee into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and a Grammy Award winner. He's known for producing Good Times, which led to the Sugar Hill Gang's Rapper's Delight. He also worked with Queen, David Bowie, and even newer acts like Daft Punk. He's definitely one of the original bad men in the music business. Also worked with Diana Ross, NXS, Duran Duran, and even been sampled by rappers such as Biggie Smalls and Nas. Make sure to take a chance today to tune into the amazing music and guitar playing of Nile Rodgers. So for Black History Month, every day I'm talking about a different musical legend. And since today she was nominated for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, I'm going to be talking about Tina Turner. In 1991, she was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as a duo, Ike and Tina. But her solo career had so much more impact, and she sold so many records and wrote so many amazing songs and had so many memorable performances. She is literally one of the greatest live performers of her generation and is one of the most storied entertainers in history. If you have time, look into her history. From the drama to the triumph, everything she was made her so great as an artist and singer and songwriter. So today, we're saluting Tina Turner. So for Black History Month, I'm talking about musical icons. And there's really no bigger icon than the legend, the Wailer himself, Bob Marley. He was one of the innovators of reggae music, which was an intersection of ska and rock and roots music from Jamaica that was never heard before and is now a worldwide phenomenon. His music and songwriting was so simple, but yet so essential for the future of hip-hop and all other forms of music that came afterwards. His entire family was generational and incredibly talented. You can listen to any Marley or any Wailer and hear some of the best that reggae music has to offer. So today, we are honoring the great Bob Marley, a champion of everything that was positive. Every day this month for Black History, I'm talking about a different musical legend. Today we're going to talk about the great, great, late, great Etta James, known for her hit song, At Last, immortalized by Beyoncé in the movie Cadillac Records. The singer crossed all genres, R&B, but blues, essentially blues, and then gospel, soul, and pop. An amazing, legendary performer, songwriter, and singer who will forever be remembered mostly for her ballads. Her slow songs had so much power and so much soul that we still all stop and sing all the words together today. Rest in peace to the late, great Etta James. Every day this month, for Black History Month, I'm talking about musical icons and legends. I was very inspired by watching One Night in Miami, so today I want to talk about Sam Cooke. He was known as Mr. Soul. Some people even said he invented the genre of soul music, went on to inspire such greats such as Bobby Womack and Aretha Franklin. He was an amazing songwriter, performer, singer, and entrepreneur who was so shrewd in business that he really invented modern music publishing as we know it, writing and producing, or ghostwriting and producing songs for other artists and bands to blow up with. One of the greats of all time, known for A Change Is Gonna Come. Today we celebrate the life and the history of the amazing Sam Cooke. So for Black History Month, every day I'm talking about musical legends and icons. And since today is Valentine's Day, I want to talk about the husband and wife songwriting, production, and performance duo known as Ashford and Simpson. Nick Ashford and Valerie Simpson were some of the greatest songwriters of all time, working hand in hand with Marvin Gaye, Tammy Terrell, Luther Vandross, Quincy Ross, Diana Ross, Stevie Wonder, Chaka Khan, and many, many more. Their production and their songwriting was just as synonymous as their own music and performances, and were way ahead of the time in doing music videos for their songs. Take some time today to celebrate Black love and excellence and look up the life and career of Ashford and Simpson. Every day during Black History Month, I'm talking about musical legends and icons. There's really no bigger icon in terms of jazz and swing music than Billie Holiday. She influenced everybody with her unique vocal stylings. Really, her art was in swing, but jazz, R&B, pop, soul, blues, and hip-hop was all influenced by her musical stylings. She was nicknamed Lady Day, and her music really spanned so many different generational gaps in all styles of music. She is one of the most revered vocal stylists yet to this day. So many singers after her took after her impressive range and style. So today, tune in to the music and the life and the legend that was Billie Holiday. Every day this month for Black History Month, I'm talking about musical legends and icons. Today is Mardi Gras. It's Fat Tuesday, so I'm going to talk about the Marcellus family. Ellis, Witten, Branford, Delfeo, and Jason. The Marcellus brothers, Branford and Witten Marcellus, are considered some of the greatest jazz musicians and composers of all time. The brothers are really one of the greatest composers that have been researched and re-performed by so many jazz musicians who have covered their songs. They're so notable in their hometown in New Orleans that community centers have been named after them, and so many musicians have learned their craft from these community centers, such as Harry Connick Jr., who is a champion and raises a lot of money for these centers himself. Make sure today for Mardi Gras to tune in to the Marcellus family. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about musical legends and icons. Since yesterday we talked about jazz, I will keep it on that topic and talk about the Queen of Jazz, Ella Fitzgerald, aka Lady Day. She was a touring artist and then gained notoriety performing in Harlem, New York, along with such other icons as Duke Ellington and Louis Armstrong. She was known for her improvisational abilities, as well as what we now call scatting and or beatboxing, as they say in hip hop. She influenced so many other singers over the years, mainly Etta James, Billie Holiday, and others of the jazz era that moved on to doing records in pop and soul, R&B and blues. She was married to Ray Brown, who is an incredible jazz bassist, and their son Ray Brown Jr. is an amazing jazz and blues composer and pianist. Check out Ella Fitzgerald. Every day this month, I'm talking about musical legends and icons to celebrate Black History Month. One of the greatest icons in all of music is B.B. King, the grandfather of blues, guitar, and soul. He was such an innovative guitar player, especially a soloist. He influenced not only so many other guitar players, but keyboard players and piano players and horn instruments. All these different musicians from different instruments were inspired by the work of B.B. King. He's quite a legend. His live performances were unmatched. People like Eric Clapton, Buddy Guy, Steve Vai, Stevie Ray Vaughan were just all influenced by the great guitar player, songwriting, and production from the legend B.B. King. Make sure to tune into his music and some of his live performances today. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about a different musical legend or icon. Since it's Friday and we're turning up, I'm talking about Donna Summer, the Queen of Disco. She tore it up from the studio to the stage to the infamous Studio 54 nightclub and many other performance venues around the world. One of the greatest at the party music. She worked almost exclusively with composer and producer Giorgio Moroder on a bunch of amazing, timeless classics. A lot of people may have made fun of the disco sound, but here we are in 2021, and house music, techno, and rave is still all the rave, and it all started with disco and the four on the floor beat. So make sure today to check out the music and performances of the legendary Donna Summer. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about icons and legends of the music business. One of the most iconic singer, songwriters, performers, composers, and producer engineers was none other than the man himself, Ray Charles. The blind pianist, singer, and performer is one of the greatest of any eras from his time all the way into ours. He was greatly portrayed by Jamie Foxx in the biopic, but many documentaries and other historical studies have shown his greatness. He was an innovator in terms of recording. He took 2-track all the way to 8-track and invented modern recording techniques such as background vocals and additional instrumentation in his production. Make sure today to check out the music, the life and times of Ray Charles. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about musical legends and icons. One of the first icons of this century was Josephine Baker. She was a roaring 20s era entertainer, and singer and musician who gained fame overseas and became the first black woman to star in a movie in the year 1927. Famous for her dancing and cabaret-style performances, she crossed over into swing, jazz, and pop music and became known worldwide as one of the century's first great legendary entertainers. She was portrayed in a biopic made very famous by HBO. If you get a chance today, check out the life, the times, the work, the films, and music of Josephine Baker. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about musical legends and icons. Today we're going to talk about Mary Wilson, Florence Ballard, and Diana Ross of the Supremes. They were the most commercially highest selling group in all of Motown history. They paved the way for just about every girl group, all the way up to Destiny's Child and beyond. They were the blueprint in terms of performing amazingly written songs by the Holland Dozier Holland songwriting crew, some of the most iconic performers of all time. This picture taken from the Ed Sullivan Show, where they really made a name for themselves and were catapulted to success in R&B, soul, pop, blues, and just crushed every Billboard chart known to man. So today, check out the Supremes. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about music, legends, and icons. It was really the Def Jam era of the 80s, including Run DMC and LL Cool J, that brought hip-hop and rap music to the forefront. But it was DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air from Philadelphia who brought it to the mainstream. They were the first Grammy Award-winning rap and hip-hop music act, went on to tour the world, star in TV shows, star in movies, and now run the game in the social media era. These dudes are perennial. Their music is just as relevant as it was in the 80s as it is in the 2020s. Will Smith has gone on to become one of the biggest box office superstars of all time, but it started with rap music. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about a different musical legend and icon. Today I'm talking about the legendary Grace Jones, Jamaican-born American entertainer, rock star, punk rock star, disco star, just all around, worked on so many different kinds of music, but was also a fashion and photography icon, a muse for many great designers and photographers. Her music was outlandish. Her style was crazy. She was a total revolutionary. So many female rock stars, punk rock stars, and even rappers of today were influenced by everything that she did. Make sure to take time today to look back at the career of Grace Jones. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about musical legends and icons. One of the most iconic musicians and performers of all time is Miles Davis. Considered the coolest and baddest man on the planet, he was a philosopher as well as an incredible musician. He always talked about sometimes it was the notes that you don't play that are more important than the notes that you do play. His music spanned all genres from jazz to fusion to rock to pop and even psychedelic. He was so far ahead of musical movements that musicians today, 50, 60 years later, are still trying to emulate his techniques in terms of horn playing, composition, and songwriting. He was most known for his jazz, but was also an incredible blues musician as well. Make sure today to check out the life and the work of Miles Davis. Every day this month, I've been talking about musical legends and icons to celebrate Black Heritage and Black Music Month. Tonight, we're gonna talk about Janet, Miss Jackson, if you're nasty, Jackson. She's an American-born singer, songwriter, actress, dancer, and record producer. She was known for being socially innovative and providing provocative content to go along with her amazing musicality, composition, especially songwriting. She was known mainly for her touring. Her Velvet Rope tour broke so many barriers and all sales records for almost any tour besides that. And she is the youngest of the 10th Jackson children. So not only was she following in their footsteps, but she trailblazed ways for them even later into her career. Make sure today to check out the life and work of the amazingly talented Janet Jackson. Every day for Black History Month, I'm talking about legends of the music business. Tonight we're going to talk about Smokey Robinson and the Miracles. Smokey Robinson is one of the most successful songwriters and performers of all time. In the Miracles, he was the chief songwriter of the group as well as their record producer. He was one of the first songwriters to really blur those lines between producer and artist. It's pretty much now common practice for artists to produce their own music, so Smokey really paved the way for people like Pharrell, Kanye West, Dr. Dre, and many other greats of the modern era who took his formula of songwriting and producing as well as performing. Make sure today to check out the life, the times, and the work of Smokey Robinson and the Miracles. Every day for Black History Month, I've been talking about musical legends and icons. We're transitioning tomorrow into Women's History Month. So for the last day, I wanted to talk about Sylvia Robinson. She had two number one singles in a duo and as a solo artist before becoming the mother of hip hop. She started Sugar Hill Records and signed the Sugar Hill Gang, who had the first rap song ever with Rapper's Delight. She is credited with moving the community of hip hop forward while also paying homage to the R&B, soul, and blues past that came before. Her records as a singer and as a producer were equally as important as her time as a music executive, pushing the music business to new heights with the history of hip hop. So make sure to check out the life and times of the great Sylvia Robinson.